Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to another weather forecast. We're about 8 minutes weather forecast. I do apologize for posting a bit later. I had my first ever lacrosse game, and it wasn't too bad. But again, yeah, I'm kind of new to sports, so but yeah, it was still very fun. And again, that's why I didn't have a early afternoon video. But it's gonna be a more detailed video on the cold front, and we're gonna be focusing on the whole cold front, not just the north central like we focused on yesterday. Again, it's gonna be a very big cold front all the way from coast to coast, so throughout the western Rockies, Sierras, all the way down into the Florida Panhandle. So again, could bring some very cold temperatures. Could be seeing some 20s, even 40s in my area, as highs for the 40s, and then we'll get into 20s for the lows. And there is a possibility. The Weather Channel does show a chance for some snow out there on Thursday, but again, still have to wait and see. But again, if you guys are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, guys. Really means a lot when you guys support my channel. We are so close to 2,065 subscribers. I want to thank you guys so much for the support. We've been getting non-stop subscribers, and again, it's just really means a lot that you guys are subscribing to me for weather forecasts, and also be sure to share the channel to help my help me grow a lot faster and get to eventually 5,000 a lot faster. But again, it's gonna be a major update on very cold Arctic blast. I can say gonna bring real winter temperatures after a little bit of warm up later this weekend. But yeah, without further ado, let's get the video. So we're actually going to be looking at the European model first, because we're waiting for the GFS out here to refresh. So instead of waiting, I'm just going to go ahead and start the European. So again, here we have next, this is by Tuesday, we're going to be seeing this cold front just starting to enter the western United States. It's going to start bringing it up to around 4 to 7 degrees below average, and then we'll be seeing the coldest up here in the far north Dakota out there, where we're going to be seeing up to 11 degrees below average. But as we now get later into Wednesday, this is when the temperatures really become a lot worse. Going to start seeing up to 16 degrees below average moving into the northern plains. And could be seeing a widespread area with 7 to even 13 degrees below average out here moving into the south central, the western United States. And seeing this little warm front finishing off out here midweek out there off the east coast. As we now get into Thursday, look at the size of this major cold front actually. Or from Oregon all the way up to Nova Scotia, could be seeing up to now 18 degrees below average. Going to be seeing very cold temperatures all the way, especially the south central area off the Great Lakes. And those going to start these temperatures. Cold temperature would just arrive into the southeast in time for Thursday. And then by Friday, it's a completely different scenario. Look at Friday now, 24 hours later, we're now seeing up to around 13 to 15 degrees below average right here in the southeast. And 24 hours before, we weren't seeing below average temperatures. Also gonna be seeing another area out here in the south central where we could be getting up to 13 to 15 degrees below average as well. And just look at this, all the way from like Arizona up to Maine. Again, it's gonna be a major cold front, especially throughout the east coast. And as we now get moved into Saturdays, a week from now, we're still gonna be seeing this cold front, so it's gonna be very long lasting. Going to be seeing up to a 7 to 9 degrees below average moving to Florida. Seeing some scattered 3 to 5 degrees below average out here into south central. And it looks like we'll even still see this cold air staying in the southeast all the way into Sunday. And then even by Monday, it's still staying this little cold air pocket. And then the warmth does take over. And it's like we'll have a new pattern change where the western United States is now under the below average temperature, seeing the most frequent low pressure systems moving off the Pacific Northwest. But now let's just wait until the GFS reloads. So it actually took a while for it to actually load. It hasn't actually gone all the way where I want it, but it's close enough. So again, here in the next 60 hours here, so this is going to be Tuesday. Here we have this cold front starting to arrive out here into the north central area, into the western United States. You're only going to bring it up to 8 to 10 degrees below average. And again, that's still going to bring very cold temperatures throughout areas into Dakotas, Minnesota, even Wyoming. But it's going to get a lot worse. You're going to start bringing closer to maybe 14 to maybe even 18 degrees below average here. You're going to start moving this warm front out of here before we get into Thursday. So again, it's gonna get pretty warm. You're probably saying, oh, it's gonna be 60 or, oh, sorry guys, I actually hit the table, 60 or 65. Well, trust me, it's gonna get a lot colder within Thursday, Friday, even Saturday. Again, cold front is gonna go all the way down to the south central. So again, there's like no space whatsoever except the southwest. We will have a warm front to really kind of take over. So again, usually we have the cold, let's say the cold front lines right here. That's where we have space for warm from the sneak in, especially with all the moisture. But here again, we don't have, it's really rare to have south, when the southwestern United States, it's where it's weird for the ridge to really be that strong at that point. But again, here we move it closer now into Wednesdays, and that's when it all completely changes. Can start seeing up 8 to 10 degrees below average in Texas, and continue seeing close to 20 degrees below average out there in Dakotas and Minnesota. And this cold front will definitely change by Thursday. Going to be very cold out here into this off the Gulf Coast and southeastern coast, up to around 6 to 12 degrees below average. And then many of these areas out here off the Ohio Valley, mid-Atlantic, and Midwest out there, and still see up to around a scattered 4 to 8 degrees below average. All the way to next Saturday, this 22nd, still going to be seeing below average temperatures here. And now we're going to be quickly looking at the real-time temperatures. I mean, see if I can actually get there. Let's see, two temperatures shaded. So again, we're already seeing up to negative 16 degrees below average. Or sorry, negative 16 degrees out there into far northern Minnesota. Again, it's going to start warming up a little bit. But as we now get into Tuesday, it's going to get a lot colder, especially Wednesday. You can start seeing negative 10. Start seeing these single digits moving all the way into the Iowa area. And look at this. Going to be seeing up to negative 19 to negative 20 degrees. And I'm going to start seeing some single digit moving Chicago, Madison, Milwaukee. And then going to start seeing these now very cold temperatures moving to the south, the southeast. Going to start seeing 28 in my area. You can start seeing 25 for Nashville, 30 moving all the way close to Jacksonville. Near Jackson. And then we'll even see 30 went up near Winston-Salem, 29 near Clemson. So it's going to be very cold. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and bye, guys.